going to introduce Smita. And Smita, just looking forward to hearing a little bit about you and your family, and then telling us about your involvement with Now and Next and Book Creator.
Thank you, everybody. It's my privilege to be here and share our family story with you. And thank you once again, a big heartfelt thank you to Silvana, to Anik, Robin, and the Now and Next team who I had the pleasure of working with. It started with the predictability aspect of it, where we were given a storyboard. And the best part, what we liked about it, was the ball was placed in our court, because we were given a set of cards and there was a storyboard. So it was very visual, it was very different from how we otherwise interact with professionals. You got a set of cards and they had multiple pictures on it, and we had to use our imagination on how we relate to them. What makes sense to us as a family or in relation with a child. So we picked on some of those which spoke to us really. And whether it was in relation to early intervention or it was a dream or vision for a family. Something, to be honest, which we weren't really contemplating on, because most of it is a day-to-day aspect that you want to work through. You don't really think about the future goals or a vision that you could possibly have. So the best thing was it got us thinking, and we put categories through which we could take it in the future. So I would like to go through the book which we created through this process, which in a way documents our journey. So this is the cover, and well, it's a very interactive app which we were introduced to called Book Creator. And I think how it was different in a way for us was because it gave us a multimedia experience rather than just documenting and just putting our thoughts across. But this involved a multimedia experience which was more immersive, because it involves a lot of your senses, the visual, the audio part of it, graphics, text. So as you will see, we try to incorporate all of those in this to make the experience more engaging, both for the professional as well as the parent. So let's start with the cover. This, as you can see, has Mishti's face on it. And the topic is something which I think Anik has inspired us to come up with. It says, dare to dream big, Olympic size. And the reason for it is because Mishti, the strength that she has is she has a lot of stamina, a lot of energy. She has very good motor skills. So we wanted to harness that in a positive way and make a goal out of it in the long term. So Anik suggested, why don't you dream big? Why don't you, maybe she'll become an Olympic a sports person eventually. So yes, it in a way gave us a dream to, you know, which we dared to dream and take it further. So that's what I named the book. So I'll take you along. This is the welcome page. Some of the graphics are done by me, and I think that was the best part for me, because it calls upon for parent involvement, where you can, it's really letting your imagination loose and you can put in whatever you want to. So it's like a diary, come a scrapbook, come a photo album, but very interactive, very immersive.
So for those of you who are new to the organisation, the ebook template itself, so the Now and Next ebook template, is divided up into 5 chapters. And so there is a template there. So some of that page and the subsequent pages you'll see are the actual book template as we have created. But what Smita has done is that she's modified the book. And later on, Robin might tell you that by session 3, Smita had completely changed the way that she done it, the way she wanted it to be done. So,
on that front page, it didn't look like that at the beginning.
each family's book looks different because obviously the family and the child are different, but also each staff member may put the book together differently, but then different families have got different levels of involvement in the creation of the book as well. And Smita has done an amazing amount, as you'll see.
Thank you so much. As we went along, as you can see, you can date it, and this was the first step of how we went about it, the pictability aspect. We were even given an option of choosing characters, which relates most to our child, and we picked a monkey simply because of her love for jumping and climbing and swinging. So that's when we really spoke about our goals. This is her, and the things that we wanted to do with her.
That was her saying goodbye to me after the pictability session. She jumped on me and then hung backwards, and I just went, oh my god, feel those abs. I said, she's an incredible gymnast. She's so athletic and toned.
And then her strong points, that she was very visual. So what are the goals we could set for her through this? And as we went along, it was just so engaging that I put together photo albums, things that were relating to the goals. And it was a very engaging and creative experience for me as a parent. I was encouraged to bring about my passions and my goals as well to the board, which I documented.
These are Smita's paintings.
And this is related to business that we are on. So things which were our family's goals. And this really helps because we can revisit this and we can see where we are at today, what we need to do, and how far we have come. So these were, as we went along, we started documenting. The good thing about it is it's also audio. You can record what you are thinking or what your goals are. This is how we went about. So a lot of it is...
So to give you a little bit of background, Smita is in around session 8 of Now and Next, and it's a short to medium term program, so it's around 20 sessions. And we asked Smita this morning, how many pages has she got in the ebook so far? Is it?
It's close to 200.
Close to 200 in 8 sessions. So I think not all families who are involved Now and Next have taken on so incredibly this sort of the ebook documentation, but many have, which has really surprised us. Many of the families have. Some haven't engaged with the technology as much, but we're looking into why that is, and we're sort of still exploring as this is a new program. But to give you a sense that one of the things that drove us to think about how can we document family learning and our interventions with families in a way that's transparent to them as well as to us. So this pretty much replaces progress notes. As you can see here, the level of detail that is in this your family's ebook really means that when we have a copy of this ebook, that replaces traditional progress notes. In fact, this is richer than progress notes. Because as Smita said, this is something that she can look at, she can reflect back, she can look into. She's a part of creating, it's interactive, it's immersive, as she said. And so that she's really involved with it, so engaging with the goals at all times.
And the best thing about this is also you can share it real time with the parent and the professional. So it's not something that it's a document or set of documents that's sitting somewhere which you not really go back to. But this is something you can just share in between visits and there and then, and you can keep updating it. So that's what we did with Robin, and I think that it really helped us to be on board.
So some of the things that that Smita and Raj had identified as their goals for their family right at the very beginning. I was finding information for them and then sending pages to Smita to put into the book. And then Smita has then taken those pages and documented where they've got to in that particular goal and whether or not they're still following that, whether they've changed the direction, what it is they're doing with their goal and where they're going with that. So that all of that information is there in the book, and as Smita said, it's sort of, it's alive, it's there, it's not just some document that's put in the bottom of a shoebox.
It's just beautiful. Look at these arts. It's beautiful.
Smita, why do you think it's engaged you so intensely? What do you think has spoken to you?
I think the multimedia aspect of it is one of the front runner in this, because it allows you to record the audio, the video. You can video your child, you can video yourself talking, you can add text to it, you can add graphics to it, and you can really let your imagination loose with this. You can bring out, it can bring out the creativity, which probably was the last thing on your mind. I know for me it was the last thing on my mind, and I have a background in multimedia, but I wasn't really looking at this bringing up that aspect of me. But it just evolved, and it took a life of its own in a way, and happily so. Yeah, here I've included some audio as well, and you can keep updating your goals, which you are progressing along with. So as you can see, there are simple graphics that I started with and took them further, explored with it. This is in the background, it's a drawing which I made directly on Book Creator as well. So, and it allows you to draw on it. Which has been the best part.
It's just beautiful.
So, Samita's just giving us a little outline of how Book Creator and Now and Next has been for her family. And what we thought that we might do is, as an expression of interest, is maybe if teams would like Smita to come in and do a session with us, we all bring our iPads, make sure Book Creator's downloaded, and we have a hands-on workshop, because what we've realised is that Smita is more technically expert using Book Creator now than we are, and so we'd like to harness her knowledge and experience to be able to share back with the team, so that we can learn from her. She's obviously invested some time in creating her family's book, and we think that's a great resource that we could learn from. Smita's also expressed an interest in presenting a pop-up workshop to families who would, because there are many families using Book Creator, and many of them who start the Now and Next program actually get their iPad ready and then load up the Book Creator and have heard from other families, so they're ready to go with it. So we thought that perhaps for them to learn from another parent who's utilising it might also be a very powerful key learning opportunity as well. And she's expressed an interest to do that for us. Yeah.
No. This is another drawing that has directly been created on Book Creator, and I was encouraged by the team to explore the possibilities, because it's not really taken as a tool for graphic or designing, but this is what I could do on this, but every family could explore their own imagination and they can come up with something which speaks their story.
Got some lovely little sayings or things too. They're really helpful and
inspirational. So as a part of Now and Next, we're exploring this concept of helping families draw out mottos of learning. So at the end of the session, we ask families how the session went and what they felt that was helpful in that session, and then they might record that or video that into their book. And then one of the skills that we're trying to help staff to develop is how to hear that story and then to kind of make it sort of really succinct and then reflect it back to the parent as a family strength. And so a lot of the ones that you've written in there are inspirational ones that mean something for you, but then others are ones that perhaps Robin has assisted Smita to kind of reflect on after listening to her feedback about a session or one aspect of her learning as part of the program. And just to summarize it, we're, for want of a better word right now, we're calling these mottos. So we're trying to just help families really distill or crystallize a little bit of learning. So the whole motivation of Now and Next is that it's a capacity building and a decision supports opportunity for families. And so one of those things that we've been working with teams is how to help them, families, to realize those in a more succinct way.
Michi is six
and she has been diagnosed with autism spectrum disorder when she was 2. And we had a lot of early intervention for her right from early on. These are some of the snapshots of her school experience. This is her engaging in outdoor activities, which are her favorite. Yes. That's when she is home. So this is what we did with her in summer. That's her climbing. Life in action. This taking a route. And for us, these are, even though these are small aspects of her life, yet it's a big step for us as a family. Being able to take her in a community setting, whether it's to visit family or taking her out. And I look forward to documenting this. Otherwise, photographs are here and there. Let's say a picture, you don't necessarily have to share the entire book, but a couple of pictures of her in a community setting or whatever she's doing. And you can send it across, whether it's on social media or you can show it live to people. And we've got a lot of positive response for it. And it lets you, it's not just with this project, it can be taken on a multi-level. You can create this, for example, even with speech therapy, you can have a book on how she is evolving right from the start. It's something which, when we were working with Chrissy, we had documents, and a lot of it was verbal, but just to imagine if we could put it in this, her before and let's say after she was well versed in picture cards. So for it to happen live and have a documentation of that would have been a different experience. So everything could be taken in a multimedia aspect, and I think it only enhances the experience for families as well as the professional. I mean, you could revisit this couple of years down the line and really be happy that this is all. This all you did all of this and evolved through it. So I think it's like a photo album for you as well as your recordings and but it's audio visual. It's just so immersive.
As far as a professional's dream of family engagement is to have a family who is really looking forward to your visits, who is working in between on their goals in between your visits. And what Smita is saying is that the very act of recording progress is self-reinforcing, which means we're constantly building on strength and on strength. So, you know, I can speak as a parent as well. So, the act, what you're saying is that engaging is engaging. Engaging in it is furthering your engagement, is furthering. So it's just acting on not just multimedia, but multi-level.
That's right.
And this is really the first time that we're experiencing anything like this as far as people's involvement and people's
participation. I think that's what you said before our meeting. You said your participation has been the key to your success of keeping you involved and engaged.
Exactly. It's multidimensional. It is calling for participation from the parent. And once they really understand the full potential of what this app can do, it gets you involved. It's very interesting. Fun way of putting things in it. So,
yeah. You mentioned that Raj says that he has to drag you to bed because you're working on your ebook at night. Just saying.
It also has future potential, I said. And the reason why I say it is because Reese made a summer holidays book with Book Creator. 35 pages long. But I'm thinking with Nishi, she's going to get so used to understanding Book Creator and she will have the skills to do it. She will be able to drop photos in and put little tag words and increase it, and then she will actually be creating her own books. Mm-hmm. And I think that has the possibility there of doing that for our kids is really huge.
Exactly.
So, you know, it's that modelling. It's you're doing it with her, she's seeing what's in there, and then she'll be able to make one for herself. So it's really exciting.
And then the next part of this is what you're saying in response to your question about how is it to share. And what we find is that we are working on a model of learning. Families are learning. this we're not, speaking as a clinical psychologist, we're not involved in pathologizing. We're not involved in the parts that are not working. We're involved in helping parents just learn about what it is that they can, the new skills that they can get to help their kids. It's like we all want to have our kids succeed. But Smita is talking about learning experience, and that I was really overjoyed to see that this is what's catching on. Because family sharing is about learning, and it's also, remember, we're only in the lives of families for a very short period of time. After our involvement is over, they're still wanting their kid to succeed as much as possible. So what would be the best possible gift that we could give a professional if we could give them something that they can take into the future, that they can claim as their own, they recognize as their own learning, I did that, and therefore I will be able to do it in the future. I acted in one situation, and therefore I'll be able to generalize and into this learning. So you talked to us this morning, you talked about the learning situation, and we're like,
So Smita, you also said to us, just maybe in relation to a couple of the questions, and Chrissy's comment, so you've got your head around Book Creator very well. How else have you used it?
I have used it to kind of share it with family and friends, like taking snapshots of the collages that we've made and sharing it with them. And it's because it's a very interesting way of sharing Mishti's current situation.
Smita, any other final closing comments from yourself?
I'm very happy that I've learned something through this, and this whole experience has brought about a lot of a positive effect on our family. It's not just through documentation, but just a more clarity of goals and starting and embarking on the journey. I think, yes, I'm really grateful and thankful for that experience that we've